what's up, everyone? Life is still crazy. Don't think I'll ever get a break from it. It's just the way it is. Some things will never change. So, today is March 18th, 2021. It's been quite a fucked up last 2 or 3 weeks. The most horrifying thing in the world happened to me and my family. The shooting of Bill, my ex-husband of 18 years, and my son Devin. My ex-husband didn't make it. He passed away before he even got to the hospital. And my son had to undergo emergency surgery, where he was then given a catheter and a colostomy bag. I did have one video out for like maybe 24 hours explaining what happened, and the shooter's two children then began commenting on my video, pretty much saying that my ex-husband Bill deserved what he got and that my son should rot in jail for the rest of his life when they were not the aggressors. What's happening with that right at the moment is the guy that shot them both was charged with 2 counts of criminal possession of a weapon because he had a ghost gun. And, no murder, no criminally negligent homicide is what he probably should be charged with. I'm not sure. Murder, second, would actually be more fitting. But we'll see. The shooter and his wife are claiming self-defense. Asinine. And that has to be cleared and found that they didn't act in self-defense before he can be charged with anything else. We go to the grand jury sometime next month. That's some shit. I've spoken to a bunch of investigators and the district attorney. Nobody can really grasp entertain the thought of claiming self-defense. Completely asinine, a waste of everyone's time and money. But that's what we're gonna do next. After that, I believe he will be charged. And he deserves to suffer, and so does she. And, that's about all I can really say publicly right now. It is what it is, kind of comes into play because there's nothing we can do. All I can do at this point in time is be extremely thankful, grateful that my son is still alive. because he could have definitely died from this. It would have been unfixable for me. I feel terrible about Bill. And we didn't get along. He had this rage towards me, even though he was the one that wasn't the good person in the situation. He left me. Like I keep telling everybody, when something like this happens, you just forget about all the bad times, and you're just that family again. And it feels like my loss. Even though he had a girlfriend, it still feels like my loss. That was my family I made. We were 16. He was 16, I was 17 when we got together. And when I was pregnant, I had Devin a week after turning 18. And we broke up when I was 35. I'm 45 right now. That was all of my teens, and more than a third of my life to this point. I didn't have parents, and I didn't have a stable, structured, you know, childhood. And me and Bill had a child. We became a family. That was my little family I made. First time I knew what family was like, and I had to do the best I could, and I think I did pretty good. Devin having to watch his father get shot and die is probably going to haunt him for the rest of his life also. It's the most devastating thing that could have ever happened to us. I have a list of crazy shit that's happened in the last, like, 2-3 months. A lot of deaths of friends and some family and things like that that I'm also going to kind of like come out with, pull it all together and try to do a quick overview of how things have been going and what's happened, without saying too much or too many names. It still is definitely share worthy. People are insane. Might be a little crazy, but nothing like this. Can't stand it. It's a torturous experience. It haunts my mind, my heart.